بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear students, welcome back to the online class, 10th class computer, chapter number 1, programming techniques. And today we have lecture number 7. In previous lecture, we discussed about the flow charts, and we discussed first four flow charts. Today we discuss about the flow chart number 5 to flow chart number 13. So let's start our lecture. So let's start from the flow chart number 5. Flow chart: to find the area of a triangle when the length and height are given. Okay ji, now we have to draw a flow chart when we have height and base of a triangle, and we have to find the area of the triangle. So first of all, we have to start the flow chart with the help of chart symbol. So that's why first of all we write the chart symbol, and we write start in the symbol. Next step is take the input from the user. So that's why we take the input from the user in the parallelogram symbol, and we write input B comma H. B stands for base, H stands for height. Okay, so our next step is processing. So in processing, we have to do the process in the rectangular symbol. So what we have done in this flow chart, we have to find the area of the triangle. And what is the formula of area of the triangle? Area of triangle is equals to base multiply height divided by 2. So that's why we multiply B with H, then divided by 2. Okay, let's suppose B is 2 and H is 5. So 2 5s are 10. 10 divided by 2, 5. So A equal to 5. Okay, our next step is output A. Why output A? Because A stands for area of triangle, and A have the value 5. When we write output A, it means we get the answer 5, which is stored in the A. So our last step is stop the flow chart with the help of star symbol. Okay, so let's start the flow chart number 6. Flow chart: to read marks M and print letter grade according to the following criteria. Marks, letter, grade. Okay ji, what is your required criteria? If marks are greater than or equal to 80 and less than or equal to 100, A1. Greater than 70, A. Greater than 60, B. Greater than 50, C. Greater than 40, E. Greater than 33, E. And less than 33, ungraded. Flow chart to print letter grade is shown in figure. Ye dekhen. First of all, we have to start the flow chart with the help of start symbol. So that's why we start the flow chart with the help of start symbol. So we write start. Our next step is take the input. So that's why we write input M. In M, we take the any number as an input from the user. Let's suppose 5, 80, 90, 85. Any number. Okay, now we have to apply the some conditions, and we have to use if structure. We know that when we use any type of condition or if structure, we use the decision symbols, which is the diamond shape symbols. So that's why we use this diamond shape symbol. Okay, now if M is greater than or equal to 80, then output A1. Okay, if condition is true, then controls go to the output A, where we write yes. You can write here yes or true, dono mein se aap koi bhi likh sakte hain. Agar condition true hoti hai to control aapka yes ki taraf flow karta hai ya true ki taraf flow karta hai. Okay, if condition is false, let's suppose marks is let's suppose 33. Okay, so condition is false, so controller flow to the next condition, m is greater than 70. जब कंडीशन फॉल्स होगी तो कंट्रोलर नो की तरफ जाएगा, नो की तरफ आएगा तो एक और कंडीशन देखेगा. इफ एम इज ग्रेटर देन 70, इफ कंडीशन इज यस, आउटपुट ए, बट अवर मार्क्स इज 33, सो दैट्स व्हाई कंडीशन इज फॉल्स. सो कंट्रोलर गोज टू नेक्स्ट स्टेप, सो एम ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू 60. इफ कंडीशन इज ट्रू, कंट्रोलर go to output B, but now our marks is 35 or 33, so condition is false, so controller goes to the next statement, M greater than or equal to 50, if condition is true, output C, otherwise M greater than or equal to 40, if condition is true, output D, otherwise M is greater than or equal to 33, output E. Our marks is 33. And this last condition is M is greater than 33, output E. So still now our condition is false. अभी तक हमारी condition false ही हो रही है, क्योंकि आपके पास जो marks हैं वो 33 हैं और ये last condition है greater than 33 की. So controller moves to the next statement, no, output ungraded. तो आपका result यहाँ पर आएगा output अनग्रेडेड, क्योंकि इसमें से कोई भी कंडीशन आपकी ट्रू नहीं हुई. अगर कोई भी ट्रू होती तो ये जो यस वाले लिखे हुए हैं इनमें से कोई ना कोई आ जाता है. हमारे मार्क्स थे 33, सो डैट्स वाई वी पुट आउटपुट अनग्रेडेड. नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज स्टॉप, फ्लो चार्ट नंबर 7. फ्लो चार्ट टू फाइंड द एक्सपोनेंट ई ऑफ अ गिवन नंबर एन. In this flow chart, the value P presents n raised to the power E. देखें, in this flow chart, we have to find the exponent of the given number. Let's take an example. We have to find the 2 cube, means 2 powers 3. So exponent is 3 and number is 2. Okay, so first of all, for finding the 2 cube, we have to start the flow chart. So that's why we start the flow chart with the help of start symbol. Our next step is take the input. Okay, now when you take the input, let's suppose we take input n. n equal to let's suppose 2, okay, and e equal to let's suppose 3. Okay, now p equals to 1, k equal to 1. Why we take p equals to 1? Because p stands for product, so we always take product equals to 1, because when you take the product equals to 0, let's suppose we have product P equals to 0. When we write P equals to P multiply N, means P is 0. Okay? So when you take the P equals to 0, and when you write the P equals to P steric N, means P equals to 0 steric 2. So that is equals to 0. That's why we always take P equals to 1. Because when you multiply any number with 1, it becomes that number. Let's suppose you multiply 1 with 2, it becomes 2. When you multiply 1 with 5, it becomes 5. But if you take the P equals to 0, so it becomes 0. So your answer becomes 0. Okay, so that's why always we take P equals to 0, and in the factorial flowchart we always take F equals to 1. Okay, here we take P equals to 1, and in factorials, flowchart, we take f equal to 1. But whenever we have to find sum, so we take sum equals to 0. ये कुछ पॉइंट्स हैं, ये अपने जहन में बिठा लें. अगर आपको ये पॉइंट जहन में बैठ गए तो आप इजीली कोई भी फ्लो चार्ट सोल्व कर सकते हैं. p इक्वल्स टू 1, ओके. p इक्वल्स टू 1 एंड k इक्वल टू 1. सो इन प्रोसेसिंग सिंबल वी हैव टू राइट p इक्वल्स टू p मल्टीप्लाई n. हियर p इज 1 एंड n इज 2. सो 1 मल्टीप्लाई 2 2. सो p इक्वल टू 2, k इक्वल टू k प्लस 1. सो इट मीन k प्लस 1 मीन्स k इक्वल टू 2. ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट स्टेप, k इज लेस देन और इक्वल टू e. ओके, लेट्स टेक एन एग्जांपल, p इक्वल टू 1. ओके जी, सो k इक्वल्स टू 1 प्लस 1 2. k इज लेस देन इक्वल टू e. E means exponent. When k is less than or equal to e, then condition is to go back to this step. So again we multiply p equals to p multiply n. First of all p is 2. Now 2 multiply 2, 4. K is 1 plus 1, 2 plus 1, 3. Again okay. So when condition is false, it will come to next step, and next step is output p. So output p means answer of the exponent of 2 means 8. Flow chart number 8. Flow chart to print odd numbers from 1 to 100. First of all, we have to start our flow chart. So that's why I will start with the help of the start symbol. Next is k equal to 1, because odd number starts from the 1 and we have to display the odd number, so that's why output k means output 1. Next step is k equals to k plus 2. Why? Because when we have to print odd numbers, we have to add 2. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 2, 7. So that's why we take the difference of 2. So it's mean 3. So again, next condition, k is less than 100. If condition is true, then controller moves to the again output k. Now it displays 3. Next step, k plus 2, 3 plus 2, 5. 5 is less than 100. Again, output k means it displays 5. Again, 7. Less than 100, again go to the output k, display 7. So up to so on up to 100. Okay, when we have the condition 99 plus 2, 101. 101 is false, because 101 is not greater than, not less than 100, so that's why condition is false. Now controller moves to the next step and stop the flowchart. Flowchart to print the given sequence of the number in descending order. First of all, we have to start the flowchart with the help of start symbol. Next is take the k as 27, because we have to print in descending order, so we have to start from the 27, and we have the difference of 3. So first of all, output k means it displays k equal to k minus 3, because when you take 27 minus 3, it becomes 24. 24 minus 3, 21. Okay, so that's why we write here k minus 3, not k plus 3. If we write k plus 3, it becomes 30. Okay, and next, k greater than or equal to minus 6. Okay, 24 is greater than or equal to minus 6. Condition is to, again, go to the output k. So now it displays 24. Now k minus 3 is 21. 21 is greater than or equal to minus 6. Again, go to the output k. Now it displays 21. Okay, up to so on, minus 6. Now, when you have the minus 9, okay, minus 9 is not greater than or equal to minus 6, so that's why condition is false. Controller moves to the next step and stop the program. Flowchart number 10. Flowchart to find the sum of the even numbers up to 100. Okay, first of all, we have to start the program. So that's why we start the flow chart. Now sum equals to zero. मैंने अभी आपको बताया कि सम क्यों जीरो रखते हैं. सम जीरो रखते हैं फैक्टोरियल का एफ और प्रोडक्ट का पी हमेशा वन रखते हैं. सम जीरो इसलिए रखते हैं टू प्लस जीरो टू, टू प्लस वन थ्री हो जाएगा. तो स्टार्ट ही आपका गलत हो जाएगा. सम हमेशा जीरो रखते हैं. सम ऑफ इवन नंबर्स, सो दैट्स व्हाई वी टेक द के इक्वल्स टू टू. नाउ सम इक्वल्स टू सम प्लस के. जीरो प्लस टू टू, के इक्वल टू के प्लस टू. के प्लस टू वाई because of the even numbers. 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, okay? Not 1. When we take the difference of 1, it becomes 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So our flow chart will be wrong. So that's why we take the k equal to k plus 2. Now, k is less than or equal to 100. Yes, 4 less than or equal to 100. Then again go to the this step. Now, k is 4. Here sum is 2, 2 plus 4 कितना होता है 6. अब यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा, k 4 था, 4 plus 2 कितना हो गया 6. दोबारा कंडीशन चेक करेंगे, जब तक कंडीशन ट्रू होती रहेगी ये ऊपर जाता रहेगा. जब यहाँ पर आपके पास आ जाएगा 102, तो 102 इज नॉट लेस देन इक्वल टू 100, सो दैट्स व्हाई कंडीशन इज फॉल्स. सो कंट्रोलर गोज टू द नेक्स्ट स्टेप, आउटपुट सम. सम में जो भी स्टोर किया होगा वो उसको डिस्प्ले कराएगा और अगले स्टेप में प्रोग्राम को स्टॉप कर देगा. फ्लो चार्ट 11, फ्लो चार्ट टू प्रिंट अ मल्टीप्लिकेशन टेबल ऑफ द गिवन नंबर्स. मल्टीप्लिकेशन टेबल आपने प्रिंट करना है, फिर मल्टीप्लाई करना है. तो इट्स मेन प्रोडक्ट के लिए के या पी जो है वो आपने वन ही रखना होगा. सबसे पहले वी हैव टू स्टार्ट द प्रोग्राम विद द हेल्प ऑफ द स्टार्ट सिंबल. नेक्स्ट इज इनपुट, सो वी टेक द इनपुट एन. एन मीन्स एनी नंबर, लेट्स सपोज 3, 4, 5, any number, okay? Let's suppose we take the 5. Okay, here k is equal to 1 because we have to multiply k with 5 with 1, 5 with 2, 5 with 3. Okay, now p equals to n multiply k. Here is n is 5, k is 1, 5 multiply 1, 5. P equal to 5. Output p means display the 5. Now controller display the 5. Okay, in next step, k equals to k plus 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. Now k is 2. Okay, k is less than or equal to 12. Condition is true. Again controller moves to the this step. Now p is equals to n multiply k. N is 5, which is remaining same in the all the steps. Okay, now multiply k. K is 2 because 1 plus 1, 2. Now 5 multiply 2 is 10. Next step, output P means display the 10. Next step, K plus 1. K plus 1 means 2 plus 1, 3. Pehle 2 tha, ab 3 ho jayega. Condition true hai, dobara upar jayega. 5 multiply 3 ho jayega. 15 display hoga. 3 plus 1 ab kar dein, 4. Phir condition true. Ab n multiply 4. Phir 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. जब k 13 होगा कंडीशन फॉल्स हो जाएगी, वो 9 की तरफ जाएगा और साथ ही उसको स्टॉप कर देगा. टेम्परेचर को कन्वर्ट करना, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू स्टार्ट द प्रोग्राम विद द हेल्प ऑफ द स्टार्ट सिंबल. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी राइट द स्टार्ट सिंबल. ओके, नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज इनपुट f. वी हैव टू टेक द टेम्परेचर, सो वी टेक टेम्परेचर एज अ f. ओके, now we have to process on that temperature. First of all, you have to know that how to convert the temperature. आपको पता होना चाहिए कि आपने temperature को convert कैसे करना है. उसके लिए क्या है, आपने 5 को divide कर दें 9 से, या फिर आप इस तरह करें कि 100 minus 32 करें, let's suppose. ठीक है जी, f is 100, 100 minus 32 कर दें, 68 आता है. 68 multiply 5 कर दें, 340, 340 डिवाइडेड बाय 9 कर दें, 37.777. ओके, सो c इज 37.77. ये आपके पास आ जाएगा. आउटपुट c मींस डिस्प्ले द आंसर ऑफ c व्हिच इज स्टोर इन द c. सो इट्स मीन वी डिस्प्ले हियर आंसर एंड इन नेक्स्ट स्टेप वी हैव टू सॉल्व द फ्लो चार्ट. फैक्टोरियल ऑफ अ नंबर, फैक्टोरियल. So first of all, we have to take the input any number. We take input n. n means let's suppose 5, okay जी, factorial f equal to 1, मैंने आपको भी बताया पीछे f p ये हमेशा 1 होते हैं, f equal to 1, k equals to 1, k for the condition, okay next f equals to f multiply k, here f is 1, k is 1, okay so f multiply k is 1. Now k equal to k plus 1, 1 plus 1, 2. Now k is 2. K is less than equal to n, n is 5, k is 2. So condition is 2. Controller moves to the this step. Okay, the now f is 1. ये मैं आपको लिख के बता देता हूँ. Okay, the f is 1. Okay, and k is 2. Okay, when controller moves to this part, f multiply k. So, f equals to f multiply k equal to f is 1, k is 2. So, it's equal to 2. So, it means f equal to 2. Okay, the k plus 1 means now k becomes 3. Ab aapke paas k kya ho jayega? 3 ho jayega. Aur f ki jagah aapke paas 2 हो जाएगा. ये जो आपने फाइंड किया था ये वाला, अब दोबारा कंडीशन ट्रू हो गई, दोबारा कंट्रोलर यहाँ पे आएगा. अब एफ में क्या पड़ा हुआ है? एफ में 2 पड़ा हुआ है, ठीक है. और के क्या हो गया आपके पास? के आपके पास 3 हो गया. ये कितना हो गया? 6. सो इट्स मीन नाउ एफ इज 6. ये तमाम रिजल्ट किस में स्टोर होगा? एफ में, ठीक है. तो ये जो 6 है, अब ये f की वैल्यू होगी यहाँ पर, f is 6, k equal to k plus 1 is 4, now k is 4, okay, condition is 2, again, controller moves to the this step, okay, now f is 6, 6 multiply 4 equal to 24, now f is 24, k is 5, less than equal to 5, 5 equal to 5, again controller moves to the next step, 24 multiply 5 is 120, again k is 6, now condition will be false, so controller moves to the next part and output f means output 120, and on the next step controller stop the flowchart. Okay, इसी के साथ आपका आज का लेक्चर कंप्लीट हुआ. आपका इसी के साथ चैप्टर नंबर 1 भी आई होप कंप्लीट हो गया. अब हम चैप्टर नंबर 2 की तरफ जाएंगे और वो इंशाल्लाह नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में स्टार्ट करेंगे. ओके, नाउ If you have any problem or question, you can text me.